welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, a very warm welcome. I'm Tsholo Koushu, and today we're doing the Never Have I Ever tag. I received your questions, and some of them are spicy much. So basically, with this tag is that I'm going to be reading out your questions, and if I have done any of the things that you'd be asking me about, I'm gonna say I have, and I'm gonna take a sip of wine, and if I have never, then I'm gonna say no, I have never. So I'm going to be drinking or sipping from this wine. It's a radiant red, almost 0% alcohol. I don't drink alcohol. I decided to stop drinking alcohol, so I couldn't find a non-alcoholic wine. I managed to get this one, but this one contains less than 0.4% alcohol, so hopefully it won't do any harm. So the first question says, never have you ever considered face modeling? I have never, but it's probably something I should look into. If someone realizes or picks up that I somehow should be into face modeling, then it means there's something, so I will consider it. Never have you ever traveled abroad? Sadly, I have never. But I plan to. I have my passport ready. I just need to get my money right. Then we're traveling abroad. So, never have you ever considered starting your own business, or you tried it before, and what kind of a business is it? I have. Actually, I've always been in this business. Like, I've been doing people's hair from high school to varsity. And then when I got to varsity, I started learning about makeup. So I started charging people for makeup. So yeah, I'm in the beauty industry. I even took a short course, an entrepreneurial development short course, so that I can, you know, sharpen my entrepreneurial skills. I want to formalize it. I want to, you know, establish it as a formal business. So which is why I took a short course. Never have you ever been disappointed by the person you dearly love? What was your reaction? Did you forgive the person? I have. Not so long ago, I found out that my friend, or someone I considered a friend, has been spreading rumors around about me. And they're not just, you know, simple rumors, guys. They are hectic rumors. When I found out, I was shocked. Like, wait, did you say so and so said this and that about me? And they said, yeah, she did. And I couldn't believe it for a moment. And then after processing it, I was sad, I was hurt. And then I confronted her about it. Like, I was hoping so much that it's not true, that there might be an explanation behind everything that she supposedly said about me. And like, I wanted to give her a chance to defend herself, to say no. Like, I wanted to get both sides of the story, you know, to hear as to what really transpired, what's the problem. Or like, I was hoping for a reasonable explanation, like, you know, an explanation with some weight. Like, I was hoping so much that no, it's not what I think it is. So I confront Mogele, and she admits that yes, she did say the things that people say she said about me. And I'm like, oh, now I'm no longer shocked, I'm no longer sad, I'm no longer hurt. Like, I was getting angry. I was starting to get angry. And she tried to justify herself, and her justification was not making sense. So nothing she could have said would have, you know, made anything better for us, because she made it very clear where her loyalty lies, and it was definitely not with me. What got me more angry was that the rumors were not true. Like, I was so mad. You know, I remember talking to my mom about it, telling her that I'm taking legal actions. My mother was against it, so I didn't. I just decided to cut ties with her, distance myself from her. But I have forgiven her, because, you know, forgiveness is not about the other person. It's about you. It's about yourself. You're setting yourself free from everything. I'm only responsible for myself and not for her. So I did forgive her, and I'm cool. I'm all right. Like, I'm chilled. I'm over it. And, you know, yeah. Never have you ever broke someone's heart? I have, but it wasn't intentional. So what happened is, I had this male bestie. We had been best friends for a while, and we ended up dating, but things didn't end well between us. In that case, I was at fault. I was the one at fault. So we ended up breaking up, and he was mad at me for a very long time. I think for a year, a whole year or so. But now we are okay. We over, yeah, what happened. Never have you ever lost weight from stress? I have. Hey. Yazi guys, umjolo is not for everyone. Umjolo is not for all of us. So there was a year when I was doing my final year in university. So I dated this guy. We were dating, we were vibing, you know, things are going well. We dated for 5 months, and then the other night my friends invited me to a braai. So I told him, hey babe, my friends invited me to a braai. So yeah, the guy didn't respond to my text. I'm like, he's probably sleeping. Cool. And then I go to the braai. I come back. I text him, hey babe, I'm back from the braai. Now I'm sleeping. Person doesn't reply. I'm like, he's probably still sleeping. In the morning, he used to, you know, sending me text in the morning or call me in the morning. How did you sleep? Have a nice day. And then we would chat in between me attending classes and lunch and. So the person does nothing for the whole day. No text, no call, no response to my text. You know, I'm starting to get worried. I'm like, maybe something happened to him. So I try to call him. My calls go unanswered. So now I'm getting really worried. I'm calling him non-stop. I'm sending him SMSs, you know. I'm sending him inboxes on Facebook, DMs on Instagram, DMs on Twitter. But then when I checked his Twitter, I'm like, no, this person is active. But he's just ignoring me. Nothing happened to him. He's perfectly fine. This person is perfectly fine. He just doesn't want to talk to me. Wow. All right. So now I'm coming to a realization that I'm being ghosted. So this person is just ghosting me. That's a very, very bitter pill to swallow. Knowing that you've been ghosted, like a whole me being ghosted. Cool. Shut up. Now, because I can see that he's tweeting left and right, he's keeping himself busy on Twitter. So I'm like, all right, it's fine. I leave it like that. And then a week went by. The second week, I'm like, this game is no longer funny. Like, so I'm sending him text, or like, oh, but if you don't want me anymore, just say so. And then he still didn't respond to my text. Nothing. My calls, my DMs, my inboxes, nothing. You know, when someone just leaves you without an explanation, you start to wonder, is it because, you know, all your insecurities, is it because I'm short? Was it because I didn't want to, you know, or was it because I'm not woman enough for him? You start to ask yourself a whole lot of questions. Guys don't understand this, but it affects you so much. By that time, I'm supposed to be writing my exams, my final exams, so I decided to just let it go. But it really hurt me. It hit me very hard. I was like, you know what? Maybe this is karma, because I had the other guy. So now karma is coming back and he's not here to play. So yeah, I lost a lot of weight. Never have you ever snooped through a family member or a friend's belonging without them knowing? I have. I do it all the time with my best friend's handbag or my cousin's handbags. Like, I'm always looking for a maroon lipstick. I never buy a maroon lipstick. I know my cousin or my best friend, they either gonna have it, and I know if they buy it, then they bought it for me because they know I love a maroon lipstick. And so yeah, I have. Never have you ever dated someone 10 years older than you? I have never. Never have you ever had a one night stand? I have never. I don't even think I'll ever have a one night stand. No, never. Because physical intimacy, it's more than just that. When you guys come together, let's say A and B come together and they, you know, do the things, they get physically intimate. It's not just that. It's not just physical intimacy. You guys connect, you know, your souls connect. You guys form a spiritual connection. That's why even in the Bible, I stand corrected though, there's a verse in the Bible also that refers or that talks about that, that if you guys, you know, do the things, get physically intimate, it says then the two shall become one. So now I'm very skeptical when it comes to things like one night stands and because I don't want my soul to be tied to like 100 people. Although there is a process to break those ties, I don't encourage anyone to go around having one night stands, all right? So no, I have never. Never have you ever snatched a friend's boyfriend? Never. I have never. I think me and my friend, we have different taste when it comes to men. I don't remember snatching any friend's boyfriend. No. Never have you ever had a crush on a teacher? Guys! Well, I have. So when I got to high school, I was in grade 8. And then there was this teacher. I'm not gonna mention his name. He was my Setswana teacher. Yo, the person walked into our class, he handed us these papers where he was our Setswana teacher. So I don't know if Kilebok or Kehulaya or what was it. So mo bangpiring e wa go kwetse motlogolo gompieno o tsena mo kgatong entsha tsa dinya tsa bonyana o dilatle. And the way he read it, got that voice, I was like, you know, when if I wasn't 14 years old. But as time went by, the crush just faded away, because you know when you have a crush on someone and they treat you like a kid. Okay, I was a kid, but how, I don't know what I was expecting, but this person taught me from grade 8 until grade 12. Like, I was growing. Like, how, can't you see I'm growing? How? Never have you ever copied in a test. Well, I have, and I think it was back in primary school. Me and my then best friend used to copy from each other. So if she didn't know 2.1, I will tell her. She will copy from you, I'll copy from her. And we passed, we all passed. So never have you ever skipped a country for Indoda. Guys, I have never, and I don't think I'll ever, guys, with everything that is happening. the kidnapping, you know, girls being kidnapped all the time, even women who are older than me being kidnapped. This is a very cruel world, so we have to be very careful with these things. So I have never, and I don't think I'll ever skip a country for your daughter. Never have you ever let your mother to go sleep over at your men's? Never. My growing up, my mother was very strict. Even sleeping over at a friend's place was a hassle. Like, the family had to call my mother and explain why they want me to go sleep over, and yeah, until now that she sees that I've grown and I'm a responsible human being, I'm a responsible young lady, so now I can go anywhere and everywhere I want. I can, you know, I don't even have to lie to her. I'll explain to her, you know, I'm going to this place for this certain period. And she's a bestie, that one. Never have you ever lied to your mother about your whereabouts? I think they're more or less the same questions. That's it. I'm enjoying this so much. But anyway, guys, that's just about it. Thank you very much for your questions. Thank you very, very much. I really appreciate it. So thank you for watching till the end. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have a question or a suggestion, please leave it in the comment section. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe below, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you get notified next time I upload something on YouTube. And until next time, mwah, mwah, mwah.